The Royal Air Force has formally handed over 25 Merlin helicopters to the Royal Navy. The transition saw the RAF 78th Squadron formally disband as the aircraft moved to 846 Naval Air Squadron of the Commando Helicopter Force. Toby Sadler reports from RAF Benson.
The flypast marked the beginning of the end for 78th Squadron, on parade for one last time. The Duke of York and Prince Michael of Kent on hand for the final inspection. Nearly 100 years of flying history finally came to an end as the squadron's standard was lowered. It was marched from the parade ground to the tune of Auld Lang Syne.
The squadron has disbanded before, and I think that's very much the nature of air power and the Royal Air Force. But a squadron that came out of the First World War, so it effectively existed before the service itself, and then Whitleys and Halifaxes during World War II, part of Bomber Command, losing nearly 1,000 men over Germany. And then, of course, the helicopter side of the squadron with Chinooks and Sea Kings in the Falklands, and, of course, the mighty Merlin here in Iraq and then Afghanistan.
The Royal Navy now take control, the symbolic handover marked with a march past of colours from Naval Air Squadron 846. The Merlins will form the Commando Helicopter Force, taking over from the ageing Sea Kings. They'll go where the Royal Marines go.
Ultimately, I'm a Sea King Mark IV pilot by trade. I still miss flying the old girl. The Merlin carries more and does it faster, which you'd expect from a more modern helicopter.
Although these aircraft now belong to the Royal Navy, they are exactly the same as they were when the Royal Air Force had them, except, of course, for the new sticker on the side. And much needs to change for them to be able to be used on as many Royal Navy ships as possible. That includes having rotors that fold back, having a tail that folds, reinforcing the undercarriage and having new avionics. All that will take many years and cost in excess of £300 million.
The transition will be gradual. The first Merlins won't go into service until the spring. Then a rolling programme of refitting and training will take place for the next few years. It's likely they'll also spend some time on the Royal Navy's new aircraft carriers while they await their F-35 jets. Toby Sadler, Forces News, RAF Benson.